Hi everyone, I'm Corben and this is Plant from SpaceX. In this video, I'm going to take you through my house and show you my entire houseplant collection. So let's get started. This is my entrance hall. Hi. So here on the floor, I have my Zizi plant, and on this table, there is a Monstera, and my African grey is obviously again whistling and making noises as soon as I switch on my phone. So yeah, so the light coming in here is not great. It only comes through that door, so it's not the best light. That's why the Zizi plant, you know, is kind of stretching towards the light. But I think it still looks fine. You know, yeah, it looks healthy, like the leaves are looking nice. It has put out some new growth recently. Very easy low light plant. And this is a Monstera, a small Monstera whistle. Well, you know, penetrated the leaves. But yeah, I would say this is still a juvenile. And there's some family photographs for you. And then on this little table, which is actually right in the center of the apartment, there's also not a lot of light here, I have a snake plant. And I think I said in my 5 best beginner houseplant video that snake plants are just really great because they can handle the low light. They don't require a lot of moisture at the roots. So yeah, perfect plant for those low light situations, because you can see there's no real window close here. Like the next window is right over there. Yeah, it's quite far from the window, and I think the plant is still looking nice. And this is the troublemaker. Then over here, I have, hi again. Over here, this is Lucky Bamboo. It's actually quite funny how this has actually stretched so long. I mean, it's really gotten very, very long. So I'm very happy with that. It looks really healthy. Another snake plant. And Hex is a queen and in front of my Hanukkah. So next I want to actually move towards the kitchen. So yeah, I have these like shells. So this is all that's Hartley philodendrons over there, and the rest I think is all pothos, and there's one Anthurium spectabili, I think. I'll put the name on the screen. So yeah, not the best of light, but the pothos and the Hartley philodendrons seem to be okay. So yeah, they like that. Have the pothos producing these long vines. Yeah, they look pretty good. They're also very low maintenance. They don't really require a lot of light. I often forget to water these plants because they are kind of, you know, up there, and I don't really see them all that often. Well, you know, I don't like, I see them, I obviously see them, but I just forget to get up there. Then moving towards the living room, on this little kitchen table here, this is a Adansonii. This is Anthurium Bupleianum. I had to cut off all the other leaves because they were damaged. This is also an Anthurium Spectabili or Spectabili. Very nice plant. Beautiful long leaves. Then at the bottom, this is a little Boston fern that's been struggling a bit, but I think it needs to repot. That will happen soon. And a Calathea orbifolia. And this is the, now I've forgotten what the name is. It's not a Tenanthe, or is that a Tenanthe? But it's a Burley Marks one. I think it's a Tenanthe. Then over here, another Boston fern with some dead leaves. Sorry about that. I actually really like Boston ferns. I have a big one in my study because I think that they're great ferns, but the one thing with them is you shouldn't let them dry out. This is a little ficus lyrata, fiddly fig. This is, I feel so proud about this plant because it was sold to me as Philodendron nangiritense. Turns out it's Philodendron fasciopetiole. So sorry about that one, but I'll do another video about that plant. This is Alocasia dragon scales. Sorry, my mind just froze there for a second. So Alocasia dragon scale. I really love this plant. I think it looks absolutely amazing. It's been easy to grow, keep it moist, keep it in bright filtered light. Yeah. Then here, this is a Hoya wattii, I think. Yeah. This is Hoya wattii. Also a cute little Hoya. Then this one is this is Crimson Queen. This is Hoya Crimson Queen, which actually grew from a cutting, so that was nice. Then here, this is Philodendron Birkin, producing a beautiful white leaf there. And so the leaves actually come out like this, and then they go darker with age. The brighter light you give your plant, the whiter the leaves will be. This is Philodendron varicosum, also has beautiful fuzzy petals. And here's the repot and a new stake. In front here is a little variegated vanilla orchid, which I'm very proud of. Then this is my little jungle corner. So you have the Monstera. Then this is a Philodendron Florida, just a normal one. Then this is also Pothos pining away here. This is a Philodendron Salume. Yeah, this is my rubber tree Ficus elastica. And another fiddly fig. I think I should have three fiddly figs. Then on my very sunny windowsill, so this is mint, I'm gonna still plant art. This is a normal, what's this called again? Amaryllis. This is a white one. So the flowers are now finished and now the leaves are. And this is like the most hardiest orchid I've ever owned in my life. It's a Pandostylis. It takes the full sun. It dries out a lot. And flowers almost freely. It's so beautiful. Then on my little table here, the coffee table, this is the kangaroo fern, which is a epiphytic fern from Australia. This is a normal green vanilla orchid. Very easy to grow actually, but you should really keep it on the dry-ish side. This is a Anthurium clarinervium, one of three in my collection. And there at the corner of the couch is Moonshine, Sansevieria. Cool, so let's go. This is Grace. She's my little cat. And the two of them are like a pair. It's like Bonnie and Clyde. Then in the office, so this is like my pride and joy. This is a big Boston fern. I really love this plant. I give it a little bit of water every day, probably like half a glass, like a smallish glass. So I keep it constantly damp, but never really standing in any water. Then here at the bottom of the fern, this is We call this is Natal mahogany. It's a beautiful indoor tree, but it can also be grown outside in warmer climates. I will put the name on the screen. This piece of Lee sensation, and this is Aglaonema, King of Siam. Really great Aglaonema there. Then over here, this is a big snake plant, Sansevieria. Yeah, really easy to grow. It's quite tight in that pot, but Sansevierias actually like to be quite tight, so that's fine. Then this is a Scindapsus. This plant needs a repot, and yeah, it also needs another type of stake. Then yeah, this is a big we're happy to forward the Cresiva with some sunburn on it. Not great, but I think this was from being too close to the window. It was in the glass. Then here on this table, there's a Dracaena cutting. This is a old begonia. I can't remember the cultivar name. This is a Peperomia. Hope. This is Peperomia angulata, I think. A straggly Adansonia, which is not looking great. At the back, there's a big Epiphyllum cactus. Then on this side, this is a Philodendron Painted Lady. Another Alocasia Dragon Scale. This is Lady Valentine Aglaonema. Also does look great for me. A very sad Dracaena, which I'm going to throw out. This is another Clarinervium and a Squamy Fern. Yeah, so this is the office space. Yeah, I think it looks quite good. I know what you guys think. Let me know in the comment section. Then we're gonna go into the other room. So this is like my plant room. This is like where I keep a lot of my plants and this little seating area over there. Yeah, let's get started. So in the corner there, that's another fiddly fig and a big peace lily in front of it. This is my this is Sabrina, Alocasia Sabrina in desperate need of a repot. This is my big Clarinervium. The plant's about 2 years old. There's some damage here on this leaf. I can't seem to figure out what that's from. This is Philodendron Cibostatum. And yeah, on the I just have a whole collection of little like cacti and succulents and stuff. This is actually a mango tree. I actually grew this from a seed, and I'm gonna do a video about how you do that. Succulents, this is my big rat cactus, and then I also experimented and grew my ficus tinnhiki in the window so it gets more light. Then this is like a propagation station where I keep a lot of my propagations. There's another mango tree there, but yeah, has all actually stuff for videos. We'll get to those when we do the video. Then yeah, this is another little Hicks mahash of plants, Clarinervium, Helena chrysum, Pilea kederi. This is a Raphidiophora tetrasperma, Haydnia ferns. Yeah, this little collection of stuff. And here's a Alocasia dragon scale. That is a Cinconium white butterfly. Another Raphidiophora cutting. Yeah. Trio star and peace lily. There's a lot of stuff that's happening on this table. It was actually supposed to be another test, but now I've used it as a plant stand. On the bottom, yeah, this is a juvenile Tetrasperma. This is Pattaya Beauty. Oh, there's a beautiful Anthotherium there. And then my pull-up bar is clearly not being used for pull-ups anymore, but it's now where my big Hoya Public Calyx and my Hoya Obima Hata live. Got these long tendrils. Then on my desk, I have my Zizi plant. This is a raven. This is Zizi. You can see it's a lot more compact than the one at the front. That's why it gets more light. Yeah, so it gets bright light. So the leaves are a lot shorter and more compact on the stem. And it's, oh, this is Alocasia hirsutum princess over here with some plantlets. Yeah, I think that this is the entire house. So thank you so much for watching. I hope that you've enjoyed this video, my little houseplant tour. I will see you in the next video. Bye.